Hello there. So what we have today is a Sony XRCA360. It's a car radio system. It's one of the oldest systems we had. This one was given to me by my dad. So all I needed to buy was the faceplate, which is this over here. Seems he didn't have a problem after buying the faceplate, and it worked fine. So today I'm going to show you how to play music from your smartphone to this unit. It's a very old unit. It only has FM radio and tape and an optional CD player that you connect externally at the back. So it doesn't have an aux port, no Bluetooth. So that's what I'm going to do today, to install an aux cable so that you can listen to music from this radio straight from your phone. And we're going to need one of these. So let's open this unit up and I'll show you how to fix the aux cable. This is the aux cable I'm going to use. And this came from an old set of headset earphones that got spoiled. So I'm using this cable instead. So inside here, that's how the hi-fi looks like. I don't know why I'm calling it a hi-fi, but it's a simple car radio. So my solution will be to trick this radio into thinking that it's playing a tape. Yes, this is a tape. Children out there. Into tricking this radio to be playing a tape, but instead it will be playing music from our smartphone. This is the tape player. For some reason this was not working. The belt inside here, it's very loose, so it can't rotate any tape. But don't worry, we don't need this part to work, that is, but we need it physically. So this is what we have. If you remember, the tape had two wiring harnesses, this one over here and this other one over here. There. So from the circuit diagram that I found online, I will share it in the video description below. The tape works from here. This is what drives the motors and everything, and it processes everything inside there with the magnetic head and everything, and the sound comes out from here using these cables. So these cables are what are fed into here and into the sound processor IC over here. So all we need to do is to tap our audio, external audio over here. So when you trick the radio into playing a tape, the audio actually going to come from here. So as we see from this wiring harness, the ground cable is the first one to the back of the radio. So you're going to solder the ground wire, then two other cables. And this is my cable. A quick Google search will tell you which cable is which. You just need a multimeter and you check which is which. The ground pin is usually the lowest, and I checked mine. It's this red one over here. So we're going to solder the red one at the top there, but not from the top, but from the bottom over here to make it more neat. So let me plug in my power. Okay, it's on. but the radio is not actually on. We need to press this button to make it come on. So I'm going to trick the radio into thinking that it's playing a tape, just insert the tape all the way. Then increase the volume. And it's not working. So this is sort of the last update. This is why I was soldering my connectors between here and here for the right or left channels and the ground. And unfortunately it didn't work. I did some more research and found out that this is the tape equalizer IC, and I found out that pin 5 at the bottom here and pin 10 at the top here were the outputs from the tape equalizer. I also soldered my cables from there and there, and the volume was too low. It worked, but the volume was too low. It can't work like that. I tried getting another ground terminal and it didn't work. Sorry for the goats noises outside. So not everything you try works, so you just move on. So thanks for watching and goodbye.